Greeting of peace. Welcome to another electric series. On this part we will talk about electrical wirings. It has three components, namely hot wire, neutral wire, and ground wire. So stay tuned and let's get it on. To begin with, we need to define the purpose of these three components in electrical wiring. Every circuit needs a power source. Unable to give power supply to an outlet or a light bulb in your home, we need a connection that supplies power from our source to our outlet/bulb. This connection is called hot wire. Hot wire is used as the initial power feed to a circuit. It carries the current from the power source to the outlet. Acting as the first instance of a circuit, they are always carrying electricity, meaning it is dangerous to touch a hot wire while there is a power source feeding it. Once hot wire has initialized the beginning of a circuit, there must be another wire to complete the circuit. This role is filled by neutral wire. Neutral wire carries the circuit back to the original power source. So, with hot and neutral already being used to make a circuit, what role is left? The answer is safety, of course. Ground wire acts as defense against unstable electrical currents. Under normal circuit conditions, ground wire isn't carrying any current. But when an electrical accident such as a short circuit occurs, the ground wire takes the unstable current away from your electrical system and sends it toward the ground. Ground wire is easily identified by its green casing. But not all homes may have it. Although it is a requirement by the NEC for newly built homes, older homes don't always have a ground wire. To tell if your home has ground wire, check your outlets. If your outlets have three prongs, then your home has ground wire. If there are only two prongs, then ground wire may not be utilized. Ground is for safety concerns against leakage or residual currents on the system via least resistance path. While phase and neutral is connected to main power wiring, earth may be connected to body of equipment or to any system which in normal condition doesn't carry current, but in case of some insulation failure, is supposed to carry some minor current. Grounding works by leveraging the negative electrical properties of the ground. The ground on which you walk has a negative electrical charge. Therefore, it's able to neutralize positively charged electricity. Grounding allows excess electricity to discharge through the ground. Grounding gives electricity the most effective way to return to the ground via your electrical panel. A grounding wire gives an appliance or electrical device a safe way to discharge excess electricity. An electrical circuit relies on both positive and negative electricity. If something goes wrong, there will be a buildup of energy. This can cause the electrical connection and housing to store that excess power. When an electrical malfunction occurs, this power will be stored in internal wiring and external metal housing. A static electric shock is a simple example. You'll only notice this buildup when a connection is made to let loss the electricity being stored. A circuit breaker will shut off when a short circuit occurs. However, without a grounding wire, the electricity will still be present. A grounding wire takes the electricity that has built up during the malfunction and sends it outside of your home back into the ground. The electrical grounding wire will have to connect to the soil outside of your home in some manner. Depending on your city or county zoning codes, this can occur in one of two ways. Grounding rod, typically an 8-foot-long copper rod that is driven into the soil outside of your home. It's placed far enough away from your home not to run into gravel, concrete, or other building materials used for your foundation, drainage, or piping system. Copper water pipe. A grounding wire can be sent to the plumbing connection that feeds your hot water heater with cold water. This copper pipe goes into the ground and can offer grounding connection. I hope we have learned a lot for our topic. See you in next parts. Again, greetings of peace.